The lead aircraft is going to engage it here momentarily with a 500-pound bomb on the target.
Two bombs dropped by an American F-16 strike home. A house outside Bakuba, north of Baghdad, is flattened. Abu Musab al-Zarqawi, the leader of Al-Qaeda in Iraq and one of the world's most wanted men, has been eliminated. Iraqi police, who've lost hundreds of comrades in attacks blamed on Zarqawi, are celebrating. The White House is relieved.
Now Zarqawi has met his end. And this violent man will never murder again.
An American Special Operations Task Force had been zeroing in on Zarqawi for months. There are reports that this video, released in March by the militant, contained clues that led to the discovery of his hideout. But Zarqawi had a $33 million price on his head, and he may have been betrayed.
Tips and intelligence from Iraqi senior leaders from his network led our forces to Zarqawi and some of his associates, who were conducting a meeting approximately 8 kilometers north of Bakuba when the airstrike was launched.
3 days earlier, it was learned that Zarqawi's so-called spiritual advisor, Sheikh Rahman, would be attending a meeting with him. Predator spy planes monitored Rahman as he made his way to the meeting. When he entered a house near Bakuba, the airstrike was launched. Two F-16s closed in on the target, the lead aircraft dropping the two 230-kilogram precision-guided bombs that flattened the house. Troops who arrived soon afterwards found six bodies in the rubble.
As Zarqawi's body was then removed, brought back to a secure location, by visual identification it was established that that probably was him, but they went ahead and brought him back, did further examination of his body, found more scars and tattoos consistent with what had been reported once we knew about him. They then did fingerprint identification.
9 hours after the airstrike, fingerprints confirmed that it was Zarqawi. In central Baghdad, which has been increasingly penetrated by insurgents, Iraqi troops welcomed the announcement. Thanks to God, terrorism has been eliminated, says a soldier. But Al-Qaeda in Iraq has vowed to continue the insurgency, and there's been no let-up in the bloodshed. More than 30 people have been killed in a string of bomb attacks across Baghdad. Ross Cameron, World News Australia.